very happy to be here, and I think it's an honor. And I was thinking, as I was sitting there, that all my life I have been a libro traficante. From the day up, day one, I think. I was born in Los Angeles. My family came in 1917, my grandmother, my great-grandmother, escaping the Mexican Revolution. And they went to Texas, and then they came to LA in 1919. And they were the first Mexican families in Wilmington, California. 1929, the Big Depression hit, and it was very difficult to be Mexican. And that's how my grandmother and my grandfather somehow separated, because my grandfather wanted to go to Mexico. It was, it was so difficult to get a job because he was Mexican. And then my uncles, who had never been to Mexico, moved to this little town, and they came back and they joined the U.S. military. My mother was, I came back to work in the fields, and then married my father, and then I was born in L.A., and then, we went to Mexico to meet my grandmother, who was a very traditional woman. So I think, going back to the libro traficante, I think it started not in 1929 or in 1848. I think it goes back all the way to 1492. That's how I think natives became aliens. And so I did a book in 92 called Snake Bones, Crafting Borders. I was at Stanford, I got a Fulbright, and I went to Mexico, and I went to study the language of my ancestors. My grandmother was a Nahuatl speaker, and I came out with a book in three languages, Spanish, Nahuatl, and in English. I'll start with an invocation for the four directions, and it goes, Tawi, 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 no maca ni huatu, ni quetzacuatu, ni matu, cane huatu ni yolotu, ni no que vansin, atepani tlamatli, tlachihuahuian, tlamacaski, tonatiu y casayan, tonatiu y calayan. And the poem goes on, the translation of that segment. When you travel, this is how you, call the four directions to yourself. I myself, I Quetzalcoatl, I the hand, indeed I the warrior, I the mocker, I respect nothing. Come forth, spirits, from the sunset, from the sunrise, anywhere you dwell, as animals, as birds. Come from the four directions. Come to my grip. And in Nahuatl, when you say initiating your local, that's how you say truth. And I believe, we're witnessing that today, the truths are coming out through the words of the poets. And the poem goes, initiating your local, face and heart. That's how you say truth in Nahuatl. When your face reflects your heart. May your ears hear what nobody wants to hear. May your eyes see what everyone wants to hide. May your mouth speak our true faces and our hearts. May your arms be branches that give shade and joy. Let us be a drizzle, a silent storm. Let us get wet in the rain. Let us be the key, the hand, the door, the kick, the ball, the road. Let us arrive as children to this huge playground, the universe, the universe, the universe. And 2 years ago, a friend of mine, Manuel Hernandez, who teaches at the University of Arizona, State University, he sent me a video on YouTube, video of basically, there were 9 students that were arrested on that day. This is April the 20th, 2 years ago. And, I didn't know what to do. Basically, I was very moved, I was outraged that they were arrested, because they were protesting SB 1070. They chained themselves to the doors of the state capitol in Phoenix. And they were very Gandhi-like, very peaceful, and there were some drums in the back. And as a response, I wrote a poem. And then I sent the poem to my friend, and then he went to the city jail in Phoenix, and he took the poem, and then they read the poem, and they sent me a message through the email. And I was not an expert like Lorna is on Facebook, but I opened up a page. And it's very, very interesting that I got hundreds of responses to that page. And now we have, you know, today in the morning, I put a poem that I wrote last night, and I went to check, you know, and we said, oh, wow, we have 185,000 people in the last few days who have visited our page. So if you have your poem, send it to us. We have 8 poets nationwide, and we can include your poem. I wrote a poem to the 9 students that were arrested, and the poem goes, for the Capital 9, to the 9 students arrested on April the 20th, 2010, at Arizona State Capitol for possessing SB 1070. Carnalitos y carnalitas, brothers and sisters, from afar we can hear your heartbeats. They are the drums of the earth. Our people follow closely your steps as warriors of justice and peace. You take on the beast of hatred. You change yourselves to the doors of the state capital so that terror will not leak out to our streets. Your voices, your actions, your courage cannot be taken away from us and put in jail. You're 9 young warriors, like 9 sky stars. You are the hope, the best dreams of our nation. Your faces are radiant as the sun. They will break this dark night for a new day. Yes, carnalitos y carnalitas, all our sisters and all our brothers need no papers to prove once and for all we are all humans just like you are. We are no criminals. Our plea comes to no to criminalization. Yes, to legalization. Las flores son nuestras armas. Flowers are our weapons. We opened the doors of our homes to greet them. They came in and affected us. We showed them the open green of our valleys, the sacred blue of the sky. They cut down the trees from their furnaces. We gave them all the fruits of this land. They poisoned the rivers with mercury. And yet we survived this latter of our days. And now we face them in this final battle to save our lives, the lives of all. Desierto, desert, give us your strength. Viento, wind, blow into us your courage. Madre agua, mother water, guide us in your tender ways. Carnalitos y carnalitas, brothers and sisters, don't be afraid. Carnalitos y carnalitas, brothers and sisters, don't be afraid. Las flores, las plumas, the flowers, the feathers are on our side. Yeah. Well, sometimes I think it's very important to empower ourselves. You know, I think, you know, we come from 500 years of, you know, of banning books, burning books and codices, erasing our memory, and I think we have to resist. I think the 3 R's of Chicano or Latino literature in the 21st century has to do with recuerdo, the idea that we have to remember what society sometimes has erased. And resistencia, we have to do that. We have to resist. And the first, the last R, I think, is reinvención. We do have to reinvent ourselves. And, you know, yesterday I was very mad, and it was so sad that, you know, our Latina Justice Sotomayor actually voted for Provision 2B in the law, SB 1070, that basically makes you a suspect. You know, I can be walking, you know, like the way I am, con mi collarcito huichol, and somebody can come to me, your papers, I said, I was born in L.A. Hey, man, you Mexico. Your papers. And I could be arrested and taken to jail. And I can be there because this is a law. The law says that, you know, the police can arrest me because I don't have my papers. No, I left my papers when I, you know, I went to a reading, and I left my papers in Davis, California. And so, you know, I said, what do we do? And so, you know, I think I went back to my grandmother last night. And so I saw my grandmother. You know, I'm now 58 years old, and I'm reading in Nahuatl, so I don't know what the message is saying. I think somehow something's happened to my mind, and that, you know, she's coming closer and closer to me. And so it, basically she dictated this poem to me, and I'll read it to you. And then I put it last night on Facebook, and I took it out, because I thought, oh, this is a prayer, and, you know, people will not get, they're not gonna get it. You know, and I think, you know, so I said, you know, it's a prayer that my grandma gave me in a dream, and, but then I said, you know, well, you should give it to me because I wanted to share with everybody. So I put it back, you know, last night, and today I said, wow, you know, 1,000 people saw the poem on Facebook. I said, wow, is that real? Are those people real? You know, when I meet 185,000 people reading poems from the web page, you know, is that real, Lorna, or is it just made up?
I don't know, it could be those.
I'm mesmerized. I'm a little bit taken off for that, you know, because it's just increased an incredible number. So the poem goes, Plegaria fronteriza, Atonalsin, Guadalupe. Madre morena, de los cielos, del mar, de esta vasta tierra. Protégenos a todos. Somos tu pueblo, mestizo escogido. Como onda rosa, siempre te llevamos en el corazón. Eres bandera y estandarte real en nuestras luchas. Parte el mar rojo para que pasemos con seguridad a la tierra prometida, que es nuestra tierra original también. No nos dejes caer en manos de la tropa del injusto faraón. Bendice a nuestras familias que nos aguardan en casa. Danos valor para hacer nuestros sueños realidad y volver esta tierra en un gran templo de tu bondad y amor. What a prayer. Tutonalsin, Guadalupe. And this is Hispanic. You know, Ton means our, Nana means mother, and Zin, madrecita. This is a, you know, the Tonalsin, the mother of all, of the divine in the Mesoamerican tradition. Bronze mother of the heavens, of the sea, of this vast land. Protect all of us. We are the chosen mestizo people. As a deep rose, we always carry you in our hearts. You are the flag, the real banner in all the struggles. Part the real sea. Yes, part the Red Sea. So that we can pass through safely to the promised land that is as well our native land. Don't let us fall in the troops' hands of the unjust Pharaoh. Bless our families awaiting at home for our return. Give us courage to make a dream come true and turn this land into a grand temple of your love and kindness. And I'd like to finish by reading a poem to one dreamer. And then, you know, I write poems for children. And this is poem is come from a collection called Poemas para Soñar Juntos, Poems to Dream Together. And I believe, you know, we have to struggle. And not just, you know, in terms of SB 1070, you know, the law, you know, 2281, and Georgia, you know, now 56, and Alabama, and everybody's now having their own laws. It's a, for me, it's a deja vu going back to 1929. But, you know, if there's a dreamer, this is a dreamer that shows a way of action, effective action. And this poem is dedicated to Cesar Chavez, and it was actually, I was commissioned to do a poem because we have a school, and David's name after Cesar Chavez, and you know, I actually read the poem. I call it the snake reading. Both the names in Spanish. Dolores Huerta was there, and the whole family, the Chavez family, was there. And so the poem goes: Soñador de los campos, dreamer of the fields. Para rebautizar esta escuela como escuela primaria, César Chávez, invocamos tu nombre a las cuatro direcciones. To rename this school as César Chávez Elementary School, we call your name to the four directions. César Chávez! César Chávez! César Chávez! César Chávez! To the north and the south, to the east and the west, we give thanks to the earth, the cloud, the wind, the sun. And we repeat, Cesar Chavez. So will always remember the most important lesson of your life, your great dream. Podemos lograr una vida más justa y mejor para todos, sin violencia y con acciones en soledad y en paz. We can really make life more just and better for all people without violence and through actions in solidarity and peace. And when we hear Cesar Chavez, the voices and the laughter of farm workers and their families come alive to us once again. Y nos imaginamos aquí hasta los pizarrones cantando de colores tu más querida canción. And here we imagine even the blackboard singing de colores, the song I always like the most. Y tenemos esa en un salón sentado entre los niños con esa gran sonrisa tuya escuchando la lección. And we see you, César, in class, sitting among the children, following the lesson with that big smile of yours. Así que, viva la raza, viva los libros traficantes, and we're not going to be defeated. Thank you very much.